Hi Pisces, welcome to your March New Love Tarot reading. So Pisces, we're looking at what's coming in for you regarding new relationship, new love, somebody new, future love. This can be open to maybe someone you've known, never been romantically involved with, so it's not about exes or ex-loves or anything like that, but it could be someone you know, never been romantically involved with. It could be a crush, it could be a missed opportunity, it could be someone totally new coming into your life. So we're going to see what kind of situation is playing out for you. We do have the Quantum Oracle here. So I'm going to get some opening energies with this deck and see what's going on. Mainly looking at the other person's energy, this new person. And we're going to clarify with the Arcanum Tarot. So we got the Quantum Oracle and the Arcanum Tarot. And then we have the spirit messages at the end to get more messages for you. So welcome in, Pisces. Happy birthday. I hope you're all doing well, staying safe and healthy at this time. If you find it doesn't resonate or whatever the case may be, definitely can leave it for someone else. Check out other readings on the channel as well if you would like to. But welcome in. If you're new or returning, welcome, welcome, and thank you. This is Mary, and this is Sunlight Insight Tarot. All right, Pisces. So let's see new love. What's going on? We have spirit, family, friends, and guides. Six is a very healing, balanced energy. Playing it safe. Six, very healing, balanced energy. Again, a lot of sixes. Okay. Happy success. Eight, infinity, travel, action, movement. This could be someone very, very happy-go-lucky, successful, very bubbly personality, outgoing, someone who's not shy at all. In your higher self too, partnership, unions, choices, decisions. I'm kind of feeling like this is about trusting your intuition, higher knowing. Your higher self is like high priestess energy, and you are the high priestess in the Tarot, Pisces. So I kind of feel like here you may have family or friend or somebody who wants to maybe set you up with somebody. Or maybe there could be someone coming in for you that you'll meet through either your family or friends or something like that as well. Or if some of you have any kind of mentors or guides in your life right now, whatever that means for you, teachers, guides, whatever, you can meet this person through that as well. But I get this energy of playing it safe. So, you know, this person just could be somebody who's not really a risk taker. But I'm also feeling like that's a little bit of your energy as well, Pisces, where right now maybe you're playing it safe. You know, I'd rather be safe than sorry. So, you know, I'm just going to kind of do my own thing here. I'm not saying this person is not going to take a risk in relationships, but they may be somebody who does not make any uncalculated risk. Like, they don't do anything foolish. So, you know, they wouldn't all of a sudden, you know, leave one day, go skydiving or... Not there's nothing wrong with that, but I feel like this person definitely they don't do anything without thinking it through first. That's kind of what I'm feeling. All right, so let's see. Temperance. Oh my gosh, soulmate energy. Okay. Ten of Wands. Okay, what is this family, friends, and guides about? Six of Swords. King of Cups. Why am I kind of feeling like that is you, Pisces? You're in reverse, male or female, it don't matter. Five of Swords reverse, which is good. You would want that reversed. And the Two of Swords, indecisive energy. So I kind of feel like here, Pisces, we got Pisces and Sagittarius here. I kind of feel like, okay, I'm getting the message here for some of you that you may have a family member or a friend of the family. I don't know, something that may come forward and say, oh, well, somebody just left, you know, they're single now. They left a situation that was really bad or, you know, and I think that you two would be a perfect match. So I'm kind of feeling like somebody knows somebody that just left. I don't mean like really recently, but maybe they've been single for a while. And they think that you two would be a great match. That's kind of what I'm feeling here. You may be a little like, oh, I don't know about that. You know, especially if they got out of something. I mean, that doesn't always mean anything bad. But I'm kind of, I don't see any ill energy around this with the Five of Swords reverse. Like any ill intent energy. Not with that reverse, which is good. You'd want that reversed. But I am getting some indecisive energy here with the Two of Swords. Pisces. So, and you're right there. So, I mean, they could be a fellow water sign. They may be like, oh, I don't know about that either. Like, maybe, because we do have a soulmate right there. This is Temperance saying soulmate alchemy, divine alchemy. Bring soulmates together just the right time. Patience, healing, balance, happiness, joy, love, light, past lives, possibly soul contracts. So I'm kind of feeling like this person may know the two of you, and they may be like, well, you two would be perfect together. Now that you're single, they're single. That's kind of what I'm feeling here. Oh, it's meant to manifest here with the Magician. New beginning. Two of Pentacles is like, don't think, overthink it. Don't overanalyze it. Just, you know, make a decision, a choice here. But then there's the thinking, just thinking and not taking action. But we do have a Two of Cups here. So if you have been having someone wanting to set you up with someone, I think you should go for it. Or this could be something new that could happen very soon. As well for you Pisces. All right, so let's see what this playing it safe is about. What is this playing it safe about for Pisces? Playing it safe for Pisces. Let's see. Playing it safe for Pisces. Oh my gosh, Ace of Pentacles. Saw the new beginning on the horizon. Three of Swords, heartache and pain, disappointments. I'm feeling like this person, I don't know, they could be an investor or something like that. Queen of Wands reversed. Yeah, this person definitely could have had their heart broken in the past. They could have even been engaged in the past and got their heart broken. Magician, but again, it's meant to manifest here. So it could have been divine intervention where that person wasn't meant for them. Could be even maybe something like that happened to you. Maybe they were engaged. I mean, that could be the Ace of Pentacles and, you know, the Queen of Wands here. Maybe that person cheated on and broke it off, whatever the case may be. But it was divine intervention. It was meant to be that way so that the two of you could align finally, even if you don't know each other, at the right time. So maybe, you know, if you were going through things, they were going through things, and now you're both single. And I definitely feel like there's somebody here that wants to set the two of you up. Four of Wands and the Ace of Wands. Exciting new beginning here. We got two Aces of new beginnings here. Four of Wands. Could be something around like home, family, as well. Before, you may actually meet this person. Maybe they maybe some sort of gathering or something like that where, you know, everyone's saying, well, you know, they're going to be there, you know. Whatever that may, it could be a wedding, it could be anything, but there's going to be an exciting new opportunity here with the Ace of Wands. I kind of see, like, if you, it could be an outdoor wedding, it could be an event or something like that. There's, I see fireworks there too, so I mean, whatever that means, but I kind of feel like someone just saying, nope, I'm going to sit over here and play it safe. Could be you, could be them. I do feel that little reluctancy, but I do see here, I mean, new beginning, new beginning, new beginning. You got two Aces here. So you have Gemini, Virgo, Aries. Let's see what's on the bottom of the deck. Oh, strength. So strong connection cannot be denied. Past lives together maybe even. But that's about being strong, courageous, and brave and going for it. But that also can be about having resistance and holding back. Knight of Swords happening quickly out of the blue. And a leap of faith here. So the energy is here to just go for it. I feel Pisces is to just go for it. It's kind of what I feel here. I mean, we do have happy success. And I'm kind of envisioning two people finally just coming together and talking, like, you know, they've been wanting to set us up and, you know, and just kind of casually talking about the whole thing and how, well, you know, I wasn't really up to it because of this, this, that. And they're like, oh yeah, me too. Then all of a sudden that just leads to more conversation, conversation. Then all of a sudden the connection starts to be formed as well. All right. So let's see what this happy success is about for you Pisces. What is this happy success for Pisces? Emperor. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this person could be a business owner, entrepreneur, in some way, shape, or form. Very successful. I'm definitely feeling that. And the Nine of Pentacles, they're single, available, abundant, self-sufficient. Everything going for them right now. And the Queen of Pentacles. Wow. And the Sun. This person is like at the high point of their success right now. definitely they're raking in the money right now. I feel this could be someone very, very well off. Seven of Pentacles, but it took a lot of hard work for them to get there. I feel like they went through a lot of periods of stagnation, and they kept, you know, assessing, analyzing, investing, reinvesting, growing, expanding. So it didn't come easy, but they're definitely in a good spot right now. Seven of Swords reversed. So you have the two, like, I feel the most negative cards, at least in the Swords deck, in reverse, which is good because it's the opposite. So I don't see, like, someone who's going to be sneaky, lying, cheater, stealer, blah, 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 blah. I don't feel any of that. Sun, again, look at that. I mean, Sun, happy-go-lucky, bubbly. Maybe they have a great sense of humor. They're not shy at all, kind of like the life of the party. Wow. Something, and I said life of the party, so something here could be about a party. So even if it's a birthday party, an engagement party, whatever the case may be. We do have Leo here, Aries, Capricorn, Eight of Wands, Cupid's arrows, travel, action, movements, Nine of Wands, Ace of Cups, reverse. So I don't feel like this is someone you've ever been connected to in any way, shape, or form, not with the Ace of Wands reverse, but I do feel like, you know, you may just feel the pressure from the people around you, like, all right, okay, we're going to go talk to this person. That's kind of what I'm feeling. But then, you know, through talking it through, you start to develop that connection. That's what I'm feeling. All right. Okay. So your higher self definitely is like the High Priestess, intuition, higher knowing. So this person could be very spiritual or higher vibration as well. And it's like your higher self knowing, and then we have the heart illuminated there with wings. So your higher self definitely is going to know that this person could be a good match, even though your ego self may be resisting it. And it could be on both ends as well. Let's see. Five of Cups reverse. So I don't see any sadness. You know, I don't think they're in any kind of sad place right now, not the Five of Cups reverse, which is good. So they're not going through any kind of sadness, loss, grief, sorrow, that they're still lingering. If they have it, they're over that. Queen of Swords, they could be divorced. But I kind of take that as divine stepping in too, with truth, clarity as well. Strength, yeah. This person is very strong. They're at like the highest peak of their self that they could be at right now. I mean, we always can grow, learn, and expand, but they're in a really good place. Page of Cups, so some sort of romantic proposal here. We do have Pisces right there. Knight of Pentacles, so they may want to take it slow. Nothing wrong with that. Getting to know each other slowly. And then we do have the King of Pentacles to the Queen of Pentacles, which is a match. So we do have a match here. You can end up down the road, like, committed to this person. But we do have a match here. King, Queen of Pentacles, just saying. Knight of Pentacles, so they may come in with the offer, you know, once the connection starts to develop, you start talking to each other, getting to know each other. And I kind of feel like by being pushed together, that's actually what's going to help start your connection, because you're going to talk about that and then start talking about other things. And then before you know it, you're actually going to be well suited for each other. So let's see, we have Taurus, Virgo, Pisces, Leo, Libra. Nine of Cups, yeah, happiness, joy, wish fulfillment of every kind here. And we do have the Devil, though, but don't worry about that, because strength here overcomes the Devil. So there could be, you know, a little bit of fear sometimes seeping in, but Ace of Swords here, clarity of mind, awakening, epiphany, aha moment, cutting out energy is no longer serving here, because the connection is right here with the Two of Cups. So, wow. Wow, so I do feel, oh my God, and Lover's on the top of the deck. I'm just saying, Pisces. So if you've been hesitating about being set up with someone, I would say go for it, because you may be quite surprised on how that turns out, even if you may feel they're not your usual type or whatever the case may be. I would say go for it. That's what I say. But if this does resonate, Pisces, please do. We're going to get some spirit messages here, see what these have to say. This could be happening like now, because we do have Pisces over here. I thought we had another Pisces card. Well, we got Pisces there. And, oh yeah, Pisces over here with the King of Cups. We are in Pisces season right now. So this could be happening now. Or maybe there's something this summer you're going to. But I do see a solid opportunity here. Anyway, please do like, share, subscribe, comment, all that great stuff. We greatly appreciate if it resonates. And everything, like I said, you need to know is down below if you'd like to check that out as well. All right, so let's see what the spirit messages have for you. Did I say the signs over here? Virgo, Taurus, Leo, Pisces, Libra. I think I did, but got a lot of two Leo cards right here, back to back. So Leo season could mean something. That's July, August. All right, relationships. Well, oh my goodness. Relationships are just mirror images of your own life, how you feel and treat yourself, as well as how you react and respond to different situations and people around you. Be aware that every relationship has an opportunity for soul growth. Wow. This is a relationship that's meant to happen here. I mean, we got the Temperance Angel right there bringing two people together. New beginnings. Everything in life is constantly vibrating and moving, and therefore continuously changing and evolving. Be aware that a new beginning is on the horizon. Have courage and faith, because right now life is trying to nudge you forward and move you in a new direction. Wow, a new beginning, a new relationship, a new beginning. What else? Mother's love. It could be actually, you know, maybe their mother, your mother, trying to push the two of you together. A mother's love is reaching out to you at this time and holding you close. She knows how much you miss her and wants to remind you that the special bond of love can never be broken. So I'm just feeling like here it could be like a parental figure as well, a mother or a parental like figure. Trust. While you're, so I don't know if I really want to read these, but it says, while your logical mind is dictating a supposedly clear direction, your soul's inner guidance is urging you to follow an alternate path. The logical path may be the one that you consider safe, right there, and more familiar, but you could be missing out on boundless opportunities and so much more. Oh my gosh, Pisces, holy moly. Let go. Once you let go of the outcome, you'll be able to release all the emotional constraints that have held you back in the past. Trust in the higher good and guidance of spirit, as we have only your best intentions at heart and will do everything in our power to protect you. I definitely feel like, you know, maybe the two of you have let things go of the past, but this is also, I feel like, letting go of fear or playing it safe. We also have over here a father's love. So definitely something about parents or family, maybe, you know, wanting to set two people up, and two people have been like, oh, reluctant. I don't know. But actually, I feel like there's a really good connection here, Pisces. So I would say give this a chance, definitely. But if it didn't resonate, or you're new and you want to say, you want to check out more readings popping up here, you could check out your March singles, your March love. You could check those out as well if you would like to. But again, everything's below. But I'm wishing you the best, Pisces. Happy birthday, and I shall see you next time.